Hi everyone, today I'm doing a photo shoot. This time I'm actually making a book about a character just now. And I'm in a park and I've done some photos which I'll explain more in a minute. But it's really weird. In Edinburgh, Edinburgh's a very, very old city. Lots of it are actually unused or disused. It's really weird. I'm in a park just now which has got, as you can see, basketball net over there. And another net over there, and you've got like mums and dads playing with their kids over there. But just to the side, something which nobody really knows about is there's this giant tunnel which has just been blocked off, and it says confined space, do not enter. Now you can barely see anything with this camera, but if you go in, let's see, you can see it actually goes on for miles. So there's just some stuff that's obviously just been left there from the past, but the fact is the tunnel just goes on and on and on. Hello? Wow, did you hear that? Hello? Oh my god, did you hear that echo? Let's see if you can hear it again. Hello? Wow, so it's totally bouncing back, and it's taken about 2 seconds away. So that must mean it's around about 600 or 700 meters long, and it must have an end where it's bouncing the sound back. But let's just hear that again. Listen to it. Hello. How cool is that? Anyway, that's just something to let you know that Edinburgh's got all these cool, weird places. I'd love to go in there. It'd be really cool for a photo shoot. But at the moment, there's actually another side of that tunnel, which is over there, another side of the park, which, again, also used to be disused. But we can go in there, and I'm going to take a photo. Okay, so this is me at one of the other bits of the tunnel. So it's obviously used to be something to connect two parts of Edinburgh. So that was the one which I was at before. And then this tunnel just now is a lot shorter. But I'm going to try and do a little photo in here. To explain what I'm doing, is I'm doing a photo book, like a kid's book, a very, very young kid's book, of the adventures of Mr. Hippo. Mr. Hippo is a cuddly teddy bear, but he's meant to be a hippopotamus. Today was just a day for me where I had nothing else to do, so I thought, might as well go take some photos. And my brother and my sister have both had kids, and I thought, what a nice present it would be to have a kid's book, maybe, you know, like 1 to 2, 3 years old, book with my photos in it, and a teddy bear. It's the one which I created for them. So if any of you are stuck for ideas one day, I would always recommend going out and just making a book for someone or something else. And it can be done really, really easily. Take 10, 15, 20 photos and make it really simple. And so this one is going to be about the adventures of Mr. Hippo. And we're going to get a shot of him in the tunnel. I'm going to have him sitting on my tripod because I don't really want him touching the ground. So I'm just going to get my camera, take a photo of him from here, and it should make it look like he's in a really long, dark tunnel. That's Mr. Hippo. Okay, so here's the photo. So just really like him with some stars being these lights in the background. So I've actually brought him further down into the tunnel, and I'm going to actually have to put him onto to sit on top of my light stand. And I've got my camera on the tripod so I can have a nice slow shutter speed but yet have a deep depth of field. F13, somewhere around about there. Really slow shutter speed. Maybe somewhere around about the half a second. 3, 2, 1. And there is a shot of Mr. Hippo inside the tunnel. Quite obvious that it's a tunnel now. I might actually go and add some flash into it as well. Okay, so what I've done is I've just set the flash on the ground, so it's at full zoom and it's just pointing along the ground. We can try and get it point up a little bit, so it should fill up a little bit of this tunnel. And we'll do one, so it's at half a second without any flash. That's the shot there. This time we'll do it with a bit of flash, and you can possibly see there's a little bit of a difference in the brightness of the tunnel. It's actually more of a colour change, actually. I think that's pretty much all that's happened. But yeah, so that's a shot of Mr. Hippo in the tunnel. Next, onto the swings. Okay, for this next shot, it's actually been quite difficult because I've taken Mr. Hippo down to the sea and I'm trying to get a shot of him where you can see that there's boats in the background. And so I'm just having Mr. Hippo, he's going to be at the corner of the photo and we're going to have him just kind of like hanging into the picture. But because of the way the sun is, which is over there, the pole which he's hanging on is casting a shadow on him. So we need to move him around until there's no shadow, which is proving a bit difficult. And just getting him hanging so he's looking a bit more like a hippo. Right, I've got the camera over here on the tripod. And again, quite a small aperture, so maybe an f11 or f16 just now. I'm trying to get the shot. That is what it's looking like. And I'm sure everyone knows that hippos don't like salt water. They're usually not salt water? Tap water? Clear water? Non-salty water animals. So in this part of the children's book, it's going to be Mr. Hippo doesn't like salt water. And neither do real hippos. Do you like salt water? You know, something like that for the kids, or for the mum and dad to read to the kids. So just, you know, simple little sentences like that. And nice, pretty little pictures. I've actually now managed to get Mr. Hippo to actually sit on top of the boom stand coming off the light stand. And so hopefully this will help me get better shots of the teddy bear and the background of the boats. So now we're in exactly the same place, same setting and everything, but I've put Mr. Hippo, so I want to get a shot of him with the sun in the background. So this idea of a simple sentence saying, Mr. Hippo loves the sunshine, hippos love the sunshine, hippopotamuses love the sunshine, do you like the sunshine? Simple stuff like that. So I've got him on the boom and everything's looking good. So if we take a shot with no flash, the camera is going to be set on pretty much as fast as everything. So it's going to be 250th of a second and f16. And so that's good, that exposure's for the sky. Obviously the sun's blown out, it's always going to be blown out. But what we need to do is somehow get Mr. Hippo in the colour again, or into brightness. So that's simple, just using a flash. So Mr. Hippo is up here, he's looking down at the camera. And around at the other side we've got the sun up there. So from the camera's point of view, it's kind of like that. But what I'm also getting is obviously lots of flare coming in from the sun. As you can see if I do it with my camera here. See, that is flare. And which is cool. I'm a big fan of flare. But trying to keep that to a minimum with this picture. But the thing is, it's still really bright, as in the sky is still really bright. So I want to bring that exposure down a bit more. And I can't really change the shutter speed above or faster than 250th of a second. So I'm going to use my neutral density filters and just hold them in front of my lens. So that's these guys here. Ta-da. Okay, so this is me, got my darkest density filter out. And if you look at it, so if we put it on this camera here, it makes the sky in the right kind of contrast. Like there, way far too bright. And there you can't really see the water or the houses. And that should help make the sun a little bit easier to see. So with this camera setup, I'm just going to hold this at the darkest part over the lens, like that. So with the brightness of the sky controlled, I now just need to get my flash set up on full power and I'm going to hold that so it's getting the teddy bear in the right amount of exposure. And there you go. That's the shot done. Mr. Hippo enjoying the sun.